For over 100 years, cross-country skiing meant slathering pine tar on wooden skis, donning woolen knickers, and occasionally stopping to refuel with granola, cake, and black coffee. Much of Canada was first explored on skis, relying on the most rudimentary of gear and technique. Less than a generation ago, the world knew of only one type of skiing. It meant climbing, descending hills, and striding across the flats under one's own power. The ski lift signaled the divergence of skiing. Nordic skiing opted for lighter and more specialized gear and track set courses. Classic technique based upon diagonal stride was refined, and so it continued through to the early 80s. For two decades, Shirley and Sharon Firth dominated this country's cross-country racing scene. Born in 1954 in Inuvik, 200 kilometers north of the Arctic Circle, of a traditional native family, the Firth twins were taught to ski by the parish priest, who felt the girls were closer to God when they were skiing. The twins went on to four Olympics, as did Angela Schmidt-Foster. Pierre Harvey was a 26-year-old Olympic cyclist turned skier when he burst upon the scene with three World Cup gold medals in the late 80s. Today, skiers are opting for synthetic waxes, fiberglass cap skis, spandex racing suits, nutrient-enriched sports bars, and low-fat lattes. Becky Scott is the new breed of skiing legends. With an Olympic medal performance at Salt Lake City in the pursuit and spectacular results on the World Cup sprint events, there is a renaissance in cross-country skiing.